What is the difference between the sensible heat and the latent heat of vaporization? Sensible heat is the heat is the amount of heat transferred which can be measured by temperature measure. While latent heat of vaporization is the amount of heat responsible for conversion of a liquid into gas. There are three types of steam: saturated steam, unsaturated steam, and superheated steam. Saturated steam, as steam is obtained in a boiler with fitting valve to control pressure. Once the boiling point is reached, the water temperature ceases to rise and stays the same until all the water is vaporized. The water goes from liquid state to vapor state that receives energy in the form of latent heat of vaporization. This means that the rate of evaporation is equal to the rate of condensation. As long as there is some liquid water left, the steam's temperature is the same as the liquid water temperature. It usually contains wetness from non-vaporized water molecule. This means that the vapor contains suspended water molecule in the steam itself that are carried over into the distributed steam. Even the best boiler may discharge steam containing 3% to 25% wetness. Steam is then called saturated steam. It is called wet as it carries water droplets. The wet steam is condensed on cooling and it is never used in heat exchange. Unsaturated steam, dry steam. Saturated steam may become unsaturated if it is isolated from contact with excess liquid water. Its pressure is less than wet steam at the same temperature. Unsaturated steam or dry steam has no water content, not condensed on cooling, used in heat exchange. Superheated steam, the third type of steam, is created by further heating of wet steam beyond the saturated steam point. This yields steam that has a higher temperature and lower density than saturated steam at the same temperature. How to use steam in heat exchange? When using steam in heat exchange, the steam may be condensed to compose a film of water droplet that hinders the heat exchange and hence more condensation. So either steam dryer or steam trap should be used. Steam trap. The steam will condense when the latent heat content passes into the liquid being heated. If there was no exit pipe from the jacket, then this condensate would quickly fill the steam space and no more steam could enter. If, however, a drainage pipe alone was fitted into a jacket, the problem is solved by fitting a device known as a steam trap to the exit pipe. This retains the steam until it has condensed and periodically the trap open to allow the condensate to be expelled, closing once more when the steam reaches the trap. The steam trap has three types: mechanical, thermostatic, and thermodynamic. Types of steam trap. Mechanical trap operate by using the difference in density between the steam and the condensate, while thermostatic trap detects the variation in the temperature between steam and the condensate, while thermodynamic steam trap use volumetric and pressure difference between steam and the condensate. Float type steam trap. The float trap is a mechanical trap in which the outlet is open by float as the condensate level rise. Then when the condensate is discharged, the float fall and the outlet is closed. Bucket type steam trap. In the bucket type steam trap, the outlet is closed. In the bucket trap, the outlet is closed. When the bucket floats in the condensate, as more condensate drain down into the trap, same overflows into the bucket until the later sinks and opens the outlet. Thank you.